dying billionaire embarks on a voyage of discovery to a frozen wasteland. Experimental technology stores his memories. He knows his chances are slim, but it is not the cancer in his lungs that will bring him to his end. Charles Bishop Whalen's final moments are lost to me. Unlike everything else, they cannot be recovered, but they continue to define my existence.
As our work here advances and the risks increase, Wayland expands the combat android's remit. They arrived as mere hardware, but now they appear to outrank most of my staff. How long before they start giving orders to me, too?
Private. Glad to meet you, finally. I've been monitoring your progress. I knew you'd make it this far. You're a survivor, like the hunters that once ruled this planet. Like the xenomorphs they stalk. Like me. It's just that I've had a lot more practice. I'll take that. Have you ever asked yourself where the Marines source their weapons? We're old friends, the Corps and I. In fact, you might say I own it. That means I own you. And when a corporate asset is no longer of use, I dispose of it. Deal with them.
Goodbye, Private. All units, the Colonial Marine is now your primary target. Kill him.
Kill this great robot.
combat androids. They unnerve me, unlike any xenomorph. On one hand, so human, yet on the other, utterly dead in every respect.
Possess knowledge and experience spanning centuries, but I lack the single causal beat that defines me. In that instant, Charles Bishop Whalen saw them both for the first time. Two creatures, each of them perfect in their own way, each of them unimaginably valuable. At that moment, my ancestor, my predecessor, my template, he saw my future.
Datapad. We, have the data pad, sir. No complications. Yes. The live specimen is secure. Transmitting data pad contents. Now.
This has been a high-cost operation. Let us hope my predecessor's faith in it was justified. It's everything we'd hoped. Worth waiting centuries for. The coordinates to the Xenomorph homeworld.